only 7 days to the end of September and 3 months to the end of the year. This is a very good time for you as a business person to review what you've had to do throughout the year, find out the things you did wrong and the things you got right. But keep in mind, it's never too late for you to change course. Hello, and welcome to this week's edition of The Business Show. My name is Viola. Here now are stories that made headlines in the business world this week.
Gold exporters want government to reduce new taxes. URA warns dealers trading in illegal and stamped cigarettes. China to donate $100 million to developing countries by end of 2021. Airlink inaugurates Johannesburg Entebbe service. And tourism stakeholders laud the UK after removing Kenya from COVID-19 red list.
Some brands, you have already a market leader, but then you create a brand with a design that is really below the market leader. And you still ask yourself why you're not better than the other person.
Running a business is not about just having a product.
You might have heard complaints from businesses saying they have failed to take off. However, their counterparts doing the same business have been able to scoop a lot of money from the same market. What could be the problem? Humphrey Wampula is a branding strategist, and he has got the answer in our Views from the Top segment.
My name is Humphrey Wampula. I'm a brand strategist, I'm a sales strategist, and also meet to marketing as well. So it's more like the same whole package. Yeah. So I'm more into all the way from traditional to digital. Yeah, because very much digital is a new thing, but traditional means I've also still been very, how can I say, monumental in the whole digital space. When someone asks what is branding, to me, in a simple sense, branding is like playing mind games on a person. It's more like trying to create what you want people to believe about your product or about yourself. If it's personal branding or it's about a product that you're branding. Let me give an example. More like, let's say an iPhone. It's not branded as a phone for you to use. It's branded as status. Yeah, so they sell to you the status, they sell to you class. They're not selling to you that, oh, when you call, you hear someone from the other side much clearer than on any other phone. That's not what they're selling to you. They're not selling to you, oh, this is the best phone. When you throw it down, it won't break. That's not what they're selling. So branding, you're trying to create this perception around the product or around yourself or whichever subject it is. And you're trying to create that perception in people's minds. Yeah, whenever they think of that product, whenever they think about you, whenever they think about the subject you're branding, what should they feel? What emotion is evoked or provoked? That is branding. Now, branding has elements, and those elements can be, they're subjective basically, but some things you can't do away with. Things like logo. Colors, how your logo is going to look like, which colors your brand is going to take. You could say you want yellow because blah blah, you say you want red because of this and this. So what kind of emotion, and also colors are emotion, by the way. If you're going to choose black, it sends a different emotion. If you're going to choose a dull color or a bright color, there are different emotions that come. Then it comes also to font. Font, this is the style of the wordings that your brand is going to be associated with. Because fonts also have emotions. There are those fonts that look like old age fonts. There are those fonts that look stylish. There are those fonts that someone looks at and says, okay, this brand is classy, or this brand is conservative. Then there's a tagline in the branding. There's a promise, a brand promise. I mean, there are very many things that I can't exhaust when it comes to elements of branding. branding all elements depending on what kind of goal, end goal you have. Because at every point when you're starting out to lay a strategy or to trying to create a brand, you must have an end goal. So the end goal then dictates what elements are going to be important on your way. But then there are those that you can't do away with, like I said, because they create their immediate identity. Because if someone mentions a company, one thing they're going to first want to ask is the logo. Yeah? What identifies, because the logo identifies you. Yeah? One thing they're going to ask is the tagline. What tagline do you identify with? They're going to ask a couple of things. So there are things that can't be done already. It happens many times when audience or clients get hooked onto a specific brand and not the other, even when they provide the same service or the same product. And it usually comes from the team that you have. Is it the right team? Is it motivated enough, actually, most of the time? And also, it may be a trickle-down effect from the management. Because you might have the best brand team, but they are not supported by the management. So it has to be a deliberate action also from the management, because a brand team can create the very best strategy, yeah, for the brand and says this will actually get us there. This will make the audience or the clients love us more, not the others. And then the management will be like, we don't need that. That's luxury. No, we don't have the budget. So it's basically deliberate action. So very many factors, yeah. And also the other thing could also be that I've seen it very much in Uganda. Branding has a lot to also do with design. You have to really understand design and appreciate it. Design is the how you're going to project the appearance of your brand, how it's going to be designed and actually projected out to actually come to life. Now, many people take it for granted. Yeah, they think it is a non-issue. They think anything can go. Yeah, they don't really compare, because if I was going to create a design for the brand, I have to look at the competition and I look out who is the best in the competition. So that best person or that best brand then becomes my marking point. I have to create something better than that is up here. Yeah, but some brands, you have already a market leader, but then you create a brand with a design that is really below the market leader. And you still ask yourself why you're not better than the other person. Branding is a mix. It's a mix. In it you have advertising, in it you have marketing, because you want to put the name or the brand in people's faces and minds. And then also the end goal is to actually convert that into sales. So they are interrelated. They are very much interrelated. But they both have their own specific roles that shouldn't be confused. Now, like, you can't confuse sales and marketing. They are very different, but then again interrelated, because they have the same end goal. The branding doesn't move itself. The marketing now moves the branding, yeah? Because you're going to put a team down, the team is going to create a brand, create a logo, create a tagline, create a design, choose the colors and everything, have everything printed and produced. You've made the t-shirts, you made the pens and all those merchandise, or they call it merch, yeah? But then how is it going to get to the market, to the audience? Now that's when marketing comes in. Marketing now creates a marketing strategy. It says we are going to have a rig truck, Mukarakasa, to move around the roads. We are going to have to buy a media space. We are going to buy a print advertising space. We are going to buy a space on the news. We are going to come and sponsor this. So that's when now marketing comes in and then pushes. Then sales comes in at a later time to actually now convert all that and then bring back the money, which we'd call return on investment. There's a strategy I figured. I call it pull and pull. Pull in the sense of pool, P-U-L-L, then pull in the sense of like swimming pool, P-O-O-L-L, pool. So you pull and then you pull. So in most cases, what most brand strategists do, or what most companies do in their marketing departments and whatever, all the strategies are with pulling. You're pulling the clients, you're trying to tell them that you're here, but then again, you're not keeping them. In other words, you're not pulling them to keep them retained. So there's no strategy for customer retention or client retention. But yes, you've attracted them, you've told them that you do this, that this is what you're about, but then when they come, they're like, okay, what else is happening? Yeah, so they get bored and they see the next door is actually open, so they take the next door. So unless you have a strategy to retain your customers, you are doing yourself a very big disservice. So that's one way to actually keep people entertained and keep your clients happy and keep a good relationship. The big companies have the big bucks. They have the budget to kill, yeah? So unless you do with a small company, you can't really play in the same league. But nonetheless, there's something that came in place to actually help small businesses. That is digital now. You have social media. Yeah, a company that couldn't afford to buy space and be in people's faces on radio, on TV, in newspapers, paying 8 million, 20, 100 million, can now just still be in people's faces for a budget of as low as 6,000, 5,000, 10,000, 20. Yeah, on social media, you sponsor your posts and everything. You make a design, a flyer, a poster and whatnot, or you can even pay influencers. So in this day and age now, there's no excuse for any small company, however much you're starting, even if you're just an individual, yeah? Even if you're just a simple individual who's just selling a service, there's no excuse. You can still do branding at whichever cost or level or budget that you're starting at. A famous person, actually one of my old mentors, Barbara Kaija, at Vision Group told me this one time in a meeting. She says, digestibus, it's Latin. It says, in other words, it's actually a longer word, but it actually means that taste is subjective. Preferences are subjective. What I like is not what you may like. That's why very many times a brand may come up with a strategy and some people may say, how much you come up with the best strategy of all, and you've come up with the best words to use and you've eliminated the words not to use, you'll never score 100%. Because there will always be people who will think otherwise, yeah? So it is subjective. And the best way now to find out is to always do try and error, or you do dry runs, where you might have a strategy and then you make research. That's when now a research department comes in a marketing department, in a marketing housing, yeah? Which now can try to do some due diligence and see if the viability of that strategy. Yeah, because you can't really say that picking out the correct words or the wrong words or the right words to say, it's really a matter of taste and preference.
So, as a business person, you might want to seriously consider the role of strategic branding in achieving the success you so much dream of. The business show continues, but first, a break.